knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
If you want to make your life easier later on, you must invest in it today. The largest investment in human capital we can make is education. In this tutorial, we will examine different paths in education that work for different people. Along the way, we will consider the economic principles we have learned throughout this series. While it's important to be educated, it's even more important to be happy with the work that you do. With this in mind, people should consider several things when choosing what kind of further education they want after completing secondary education. One should look at expenses, the rate of return based on those expenses, availability of training in desired fields, and the time required to complete the post-secondary program chosen. Let's say you enjoy building things. Specifically, you are considering becoming either a welder or carpenter. For the sake of this example, let's say you enjoy both welding and carpentry equally. First, how expensive will it be to become either a welder or carpenter? If you decide to start learning the trades on your own, you will have to invest in your own equipment and supplies. This could cost thousands of dollars. Learning the trades on your own is also risky, since you would need guidance for such specialized fields. Also, for many trades, local governments require certification, which is an official document that proves you are skilled. Even if governments don't require you to be certified, it can be difficult finding work if you are not certified. In the case of welding and carpentry, let's say certification is not required. For both trades, you can enroll in programs at technical schools in order to gain skills. This could also cost you thousands of dollars. However, the second thing to consider is the rate of return based on those expenses, also known as return on investment. You find out that the average salary for a carpenter is $3,000 higher than the average salary for a welder. Next, you consider the availability of training in both trades. As it turns out, there's a great carpentry program at a school 5 miles from your house, but the nearest welding program is 30 miles away. Finally, you consider the time required to complete the programs. The carpentry program can be completed in 3 years, but the welding program can be completed in 2 years. Based on all this information, you decide you will go with carpentry due to the program being nearby and the higher return on investment as a career. However, your mind may change. You may be halfway through your carpentry program and realize that you really wanted to do welding all along. This is perfectly normal and brings up a new set of decisions to make. Let's consider a second example, one that requires additional training. Say you want to become a doctor. For the sake of this example, let's say you are considering becoming either a radiologist or a cardiologist, and you feel you would enjoy both equally. In order to become either, you will need to complete an undergraduate degree at a college, which usually takes 4 years, followed by 4 years of medical school. In order to become a radiologist, you would then need an additional 1 year internship, followed by 4 years of residency training in diagnostic radiology. In order to become a cardiologist, you would need 3 years of residency training, followed by 3 more years in a cardiology fellowship. Altogether, becoming a radiologist would require 13 years of training, and becoming a cardiologist would require 14 years of training. All of this training for both careers would cost you tens of thousands of dollars. Fortunately, there are plenty of colleges and medical schools that offer wonderful training opportunities if you can gain admittance. Finally, there is the rate of return based on all those expenses to consider. Let's say that as a radiologist, you can expect your starting salary to be at least $20,000 more per year than a starting salary as a cardiologist. Perhaps, based on this information, you conclude that the most economically sound choice is to become a radiologist, as it would require less training, yet you'd earn more money. No matter what career path you end up choosing, you must consider the different types of colleges. First, there are public colleges and private colleges. Public colleges are funded by local and state governments, and almost always offer lower tuition rates than private colleges, especially for students who are residents of that state. Private colleges depend on tuition, fees, and donors to operate. While private colleges are almost always more expensive, many of them have a distinguished reputation. There are also for-profit colleges. These tend to have higher costs, and their reputations are often not as distinguished as nonprofit, private, and public colleges. Finally, while most colleges offer four-year programs that lead to a bachelor's degree, others are two-year colleges that offer programs that lead to a certificate or an associate degree. Community colleges, vocational technical colleges, and career colleges are included in this category. Most of us are aware that post-secondary education is generally quite expensive, and in recent decades, the cost has increased exponentially. However, financial aid is often available for whatever post-secondary option you choose. In addition to paying for schools out of pocket, you can apply for grants and scholarships to help cover the costs. There is also the option of student loans. However, one should avoid borrowing huge amounts of money to pay for post-secondary education unless it's absolutely necessary, as you don't want to accumulate too much debt, and interest rates can often be higher than 5%. In the United States, student loan debt has become an enormous problem, and many have called for the government to forgive loan debt, as it has become nearly impossible for millions of college graduates to pay it back. In many other countries, public post-secondary education is provided for every citizen at no additional cost to them. However, you shouldn't let the high cost of post-secondary education completely discourage you from pursuing a career you are passionate about. It is simply a decision that should not be taken lightly, as the cost must lead to a lucrative career in order to be worth it. As we learned in the very beginning of this series, economics is the study of how we make choices based on scarcity. You have many choices to make for the rest of your life. Hopefully, you continue to value education when making those choices, as education is the most impactful investment you can make in yourself. So go forth and make smart choices, and think like an economist when doing so.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.